Welcome back. Leeds United have beaten Coventry by 2-0 to go to the top of the First Division. That's because Manchester United lost this afternoon, somewhat surprisingly, at home to Nottingham Forest. To complete the First Division picture this afternoon, let's rejoin Bob Hall.
Championship for the first time in a generation. For both the region's other First Division sides, Sheffield Wednesday and Sheffield United have crucial roles to play. Wednesday could just steal the title at the death, and United play Leeds on Sunday in a Yorkshire derby which could decide the championship. Simon Schofield reports.
Every picture tells a story. Long ticket queues at Elland Road today bearing witness to the massive interest in a soccer drama involving all three First Division Yorkshire teams. West Ham's unexpected defeat of Manchester United last night gives Leeds United their best chance of football's greatest prize since the early 70s, when goals like this one earned them the title of Super Leeds. But the odds on Sheffield Wednesday have also been slashed. At one time, 200-1 shots for the title. The best price on the Owls today, a measly 14-1. Leeds now firm favourites at 11-4 on. And the final ingredient in a real Yorkshire soccer hot pot, inform Sheffield United. They play Leeds on Sunday. The mathematics mean that a victory for Leeds could win them the championship. A win for Sheffield would help Wednesday no end.
You unconsciously go out and help Sheffield Wednesday then in the fight against the old rivals Leeds?
No, there's no way you can go out and say you'll help anybody. You help yourself in life. Nobody's helped me particularly along the way, so I get on with accepting that we will help ourselves and not rely on anybody else. If you rely on anybody else in life, you usually get let down.
I know we can do it. I know the possibility's there for us to do it. So it's not a question of hope. It's a question of knowing what we can do. But obviously, I've been in the game a long time, and I know that a lot of things can go wrong.
The Leeds fans, though, in no doubt whatsoever.
Oh, they're going to win it dead easy, both games. Sheffield will take 2-1 to Leeds, and then an easy game next week, 3-0.
That's our championship, is that, definitely. It's going to come up this side of the Pennines, not that side.
Wednesday fans only daring to hope.
There's a chance, a slight one, but there's a chance.
Well, obviously, if you're going to get 6 points, then the teams have got to slip up.
Well, we're still hopeful. My family don't mind Manchester United winning and get it top of the minute, but they don't want Leeds to do it.
But the Wednesday fans are putting their money where their hearts are.
I think because the pundits have been writing Sheffield Wednesday's chances off all year, the average fan has been annoyed by that and they've been coming in and backing their side.
The odds, though, not always accurate. Here's how one expert rated Leeds' chances on calendar back in August.
Leeds have got a tremendous chance and really well fancied by some shrewd judges, Nett and Bice. 12-1.
We haven't had the odds from Sheffield. Let's have the odds from Sheffield.
It's 150-1 against Sheffield United. Of course, they didn't win a game until December the 22nd last year. So once again, they've got to get out of the traps. Sheffield Wednesday, 66-1.
Leeds training today and Wednesday, of course, are both much shorter prices than that now. It could all change again, though, after Sunday.
Yes, indeed. Well, Britain's very
field. Well, Leeds are now favourites to win the title, but Sheffield Wednesday could also take it. United, though, may have their plans ruined if they're beaten by Sheffield United on Sunday. Well, in a moment, we'll be speaking to Blades manager Dave Bassett. But first, it's to Leeds manager Howard Wilkinson. Now, I put it to him that the season is building up to a tremendous climax.
Well, when we started the season, we could have hoped for no better than to be in with a shout for the championship the last two games. And obviously, the fact that we're going down to Sheffield United, I mean, it might have been Sheffield Wednesday, but Sheffield Wednesday is still deeply involved. So Yorkshire, very, very much this weekend, it will be the focus, I would think, of most of football.
You're like Dave Bassett, you're a good mate of his, but he'll give you nothing on Sunday. You'll get no favours from him, and the whole of Sheffield is against you. Wednesday,
I wouldn't be so sure. I was out with him last night, and I promised I'd find him a personal sponsor for next season. And I am wearing a clue today, but I can't reveal the name of the personal sponsor. But he told me last night that he thought Sunday would not be too difficult for us.
Tremendous atmosphere is going to be there, and basically it's in your hands now. If you win both games, no one can catch you.
Well, that's the only thing that's changed. Everyone is talking about what's changed and this and that and the other and how we are now favourites. But as far as I'm concerned, and I hope as far as the players are concerned, I think that's the case. Nothing's changed. We've still got to play football matches and we've got to try and win them. But the fact is that now we are in a position which we deservedly have achieved. And now if we do our business, people can't do anything about it. But obviously Sheffield United and Norwich the week after will be doing their best.
The moment that you were back in the race in a big way happened last night. Now this is the goal scored by West Ham United. What were you doing at this moment? Come on, be honest.
I was in my car at the time, actually, driving home, and I was listening to a tape of a novel, purposefully. I'd decided I wasn't going to listen to it.
Howard Wilkinson. Well, let's move down to Sheffield now. Dave Bassett is on the line. Dave, a personal sponsor from Mr. Wilkinson. That's very generous of him, isn't it?
Yeah, well, Howard's a very generous man. Now I can work out why Barclays Bank never lend me any money.
No sponsors, please, on the BBC. It's obviously going to be a tremendous atmosphere down there. The whole of Sheffield are rooting for you to win. It's an unusual situation. Wednesday fans desperately want you to beat Leeds.
Yeah, I expect they do. It's obviously one of those unique situations that happens from time to time. But it's good for Yorkshire football, and Sunday sets itself up for an exciting day.
You've really played well recently. I mean, the form books really would put you in the top two if the season could start in January.
Well, actually, we've just written to the league asking them to extend the season by another 20 games.
Why have you played so well, though, Dave? I mean, I know that you were saying before that you've actually played good football for most of the year, but it's just come good, hasn't it, from January onwards?
Well, we didn't necessarily start off as we intended to. The results weren't good enough, and as Howard rightly pointed out earlier, you end up where you deserve, and if we'd done our business earlier in the season, we might have been up there challenging ourselves, but we didn't. But we're obviously delighted with our second half of the season performances.
The truth is, you will give Leeds absolutely nothing on Sunday. It will be the match of the season to a certain extent, won't it?
Well, it's an important game for us at the end of the season. It's a big crowd, the nation look on you to do something. We will do our best, and really, at the end of the day, we won't be doing anything for Leeds United, Sheffield United or Manchester United. We'll be doing it for Sheffield United.
You've enjoyed yourself, haven't you, the last few weeks? I mean, there are times when I'm sure when you've been under a little bit of pressure from results and so forth, but now you're getting a few accolades, and it must be a nice feeling.
Well, I've never had much credit in my life, so I don't expect it. We can't even get credit for Mercantile.
You're a better dressed person than Howard Wilkinson on this occasion, anyway, I can tell you that.
Well, on occasions, I know he says he's better dressed than I am.
Dave, good luck. It'll be a tremendous atmosphere. Good luck to you, Sheffield Wednesday, and Leeds United on Sunday. Great to talk to you.
Thank you very much.
Great characters as well.
Could ruin it all. We have a team playing at Wembley, and there are others fighting for promotion and relegation. But I suppose the key is held by Sheffield United. Well, there's no doubt about it. It's Sheffield United's biggest game of the season, and 30,000 fans will be at Bramall Lane to watch it. There have been queues at the office all week as supporters clamour for tickets before they all run out. They know, as well as everybody else, that victory could ruin Leeds United's chances of winning the title. The fans are confident of a Blades win and are well aware that if they do win, it could help arch-rivals Wednesday take the title.
I think it'll be an hard match, obviously. It's important for Leeds, but I hope United can win. I think they will do it.
And that could, in fact, help your arch-rival Sheffield Wednesday. How do you feel about that?
Well, I'd rather have Wednesday winning the league than Manchester or Leeds. Well,
Leeds are a very good side. We're in good form. They've got all to play for. Never know.
I'd like them to win, but I don't want Wednesday to go to top. Simple as that.
You don't want Sheffield Wednesday to win the championship?
Anything but Wednesday winning the championship.
Divided loyalties, but inside the ground, and the players are being put through their paces in preparation for the game. The Blades are the in-form side. Indeed, had the league started on January the 1st, they'd have been top of it. And some of that success belongs to this man, leading goalscorer with 16 goals, Brian Dean.
We seem to get stronger as the season goes on. Yeah, I think, you know, looking back, because a lot of teams tail off February, March time. So, you know, we expected to put in a good run.
Dino, the man to watch. The team news is that Kevin Gage stands a 50-50 chance of playing, but Simon Tracy is out with a shoulder injury. But if all the results go favourably for them, Leeds United will be Division 1 champions on Sunday tea time. But even if Manchester United win as well, Leeds know that provided they pick up 6 points from the two remaining games, then nobody will be able to catch them.
The pitch is, for the first time in the season, is clear now. We've got two games left, same as United, and if we win both of them, we win the championship. But saying that, it isn't going to be easy. If we had the choice of teams to play this Sunday, we certainly wouldn't have chosen Sheffield United. There's a lot more teams that I could have thought of, but we've got to play them. They are the informed team, along with Arsenal, and it's going to be a hell of a game.
Well, on the team news front, Gordon Strachan has been the main worry for Leeds all week. He didn't train this morning, but the word is that he should be fit for Sunday. Now, over in the Wednesday camp at
Key, but Chris Fairclough's goal against Coventry, coming an hour after news of United's failure against Forest, really lit the fires. At this critical stage, fate is just as important as football, and the linesman's error could play a big part in the title. A penalty, wrongly awarded for handball, and Coventry's Lloyd McGrath wrongly sent off. Gary McAllister, the only man in this sorry incident, who got it right. 2-0, and for Leeds, the real possibility of their first title since 1974. Just a week ago, one...
You're quite right, and effectively it could even be over tomorrow after those
exactly,
two games.
Exactly, because if Leeds win in the morning and United lose at Anfield, right, it's all over.
It's amazing. I mean, both teams to me have never looked as though either of them have wanted it. They've been saying to the other team, look, you take it. Particularly in Manchester United's case, really, they've had enough chances to have got away from the situation and allowed themselves the luxury of getting beat at, say, West Ham the other night and still have enough points in the bag, but it hasn't happened.
Well, we've always said that the games in hand were never points in hand.
They never are,
are
they?
That's the way it's worked out, because looking at the table now, they've caught up in games and there you are, Leeds
are on top. And better goal average.
That's going to be a key factor, I think, Jim, at the end of the day.
It's a great advantage.
Isn't
to
it?
Them.
You know, it's like another point.
And that's why you have to rule out Sheffield Wednesday, really, because they're going to have to really win both games, and even then their goal average is not sufficient, because you can't really see Leeds United, or Manchester for that matter, losing two games out of the last two. They're going to win one each, I would think. Leeds' home game, their last game of the season, is against Norwich. And you really can't see Leeds United losing that game.
Unless something happens, as happened in the previous weeks, where they drew at home against West Ham.
That's absolutely right. As I say, I mean, to me, Manchester United have thrown this away. I don't know for what reason. It's just one of those things. But they should have been in this position now of allowing themselves the luxury of losing a game, which they did do in the week, but still have enough in hand. It hasn't happened. The driving seat is firmly set there with Leeds United totally in control now.
So, I mean,
and I don't think you and I would have said that a few weeks ago.
No, we wouldn't. And so we're looking forward to that.
Or anybody for that matter, even Alan Wilkinson.
Yeah, I know. Looking forward to that one tomorrow. And a great doubleheader.
Be great.